Famed fashion designer Michelle Smith joins us from her home. Michelle, let me correct the record. First of all, you didn't leave fashion. You left that brand to find your truth and the new space, if you will, that you're in now. It's such a fascinating story. I saw the article in one of the papers about you, and I thought, I just want to know more of how this happened. Why did you decide at this point it was important for you to share this empowering story?
Well, I think so many people are going through changes in their life, and it's always, it's difficult. And I hope that I can inspire people with my story of change and choosing happiness over, you know, stress.
You know, going back to how you started this label, and as I said, you know, people, it was a world-renowned label, but some folks don't know Millie, but you know stores like Bloomingdale's, Neiman Saks, all of that. If you're in that store, you have made it. Those fashion labels matter to a lot of people who shop. And this all started with your then husband, Andrew. You were working at his family's coat company and you started dating, eventually you got married, and then you together formed this brand. It seems like the perfect story for someone especially who has dreamt of something like this.
Correct. And it worked really well for a long time because our roles were very different. It's not always easy to be married to your business partner and work together, go home together, have children together. But as our roles were very different, mine being creative and his being more of the financial and production side, it worked very well until it didn't. Yeah.
It worked so well that, as I pointed out, Michelle Obama wore your dress for her official portrait that hangs in the Smithsonian. I mean, for a designer, I can't think of something that is a higher compliment. So your life was, as they say, on cloud nine.
Yes, I mean, that was the ultimate honor to have Mrs. Obama wear my design and her official portrait. It still takes my breath away when I think about it, and to be a small part of American history, such an honor.
So you're a part of American history, and then it falls apart. It starts to crumble around the economic downturn that many people and many designers were experiencing. You started to feel it as well, which seems crazy. You're on every celebrity's list, but your brand and the business was struggling. What happened?
Correct. Well, I think it became such a crazy carousel after so much time and so many years of designing so many collections. I mean, by the last few years, I was designing, you know, well over 27 collections a year, thousands of styles a year. And I got to the point where it stopped being fun, and you can't turn on and off creativity just like that. It's not making a spreadsheet.
How does it start fun anymore? You're so successful. It's everywhere, $50 million sales annually. How does success stop being fun?
The pressure to create under those time constraints and with, you know, weathering economic downturns and, you know, just also I think the dysfunctionality within the business because of my divorce was really the downfall.
Was the end of your marriage related to the hardship that you were experiencing with the brand? Because I can't imagine my husband being my business partner. We've started this together. Now we're having issues and the business that we're running together is having issues. That sounds like a recipe for a nightmare Lifetime movie.
Yes, it became very difficult. It was stressful to work with the person that you're separated from. It was a pressure cooker, very dysfunctional by the end. You realize that it's time to move on when you know that you'll be happier alone. It's a very strong, empowering feeling.
Well, you mentioned you have two children, teenagers, and workout was a part of your, you know, reboot. Suddenly you find yourself attracted to someone in that same world, the workout world. It turns out that you had fallen, is it fair to say fallen in love with your Soul Cycle instructor, very famous one, Stacey Griffith.
Yes, we did fall in love. She's amazing.
Were you surprised that you had fallen in love with another woman? I mean, was this always something in the back of the mind?
No,
how do you explain
it's not
it?
Anything. It's not anything I expected. Just it happened. I was more attracted to, I wasn't seeing her for her gender. I saw her for her energy and her beautiful light. And it felt very natural. And I wasn't scared at all. And my family was very accepting of it and my friends. So
Were they surprised?
I didn't feel any sort of torment or conflict.
Were they surprised? I mean, they were supportive, but were they surprised?
They were, because I'd always had a very, you know, traditionally heterosexual life. And up until that point, I never felt attractions to a woman before. This is my first time, but now my life is very different, and the way I perceive people and perceive love is very different. I identify as pansexual.
You're now 48-ish?
Yes, I just turned 48.
You just turned 48.
Last week.
Last week, happy belated birthday. You have a new fashion line called Michelle Smith. Do you feel that this represents who you are now? When we started the show, we talked about, you know, having to leave things behind to live a forward life, your truth. Is this your truth now?
Yes, this collection is very much a clean slate, and it's what I'm feeling now and what I think we need now. It's a calming, neutral palette for the turbulent times we're going through right now. And, you know, going through the COVID crisis, I think we're all craving that comfort. We've gotten used to comfort, but I wanted to deliver that in a more sort of sensual and luxurious way.
It is a beautiful collection. Congratulations. I love the contrast of this collection to the past collection, both representing these big changes in your life. Well, I just think it's an incredible story. I'm a fan of not just the brand, but your ability to, I think, inspire people to live their truth, whatever that is.